Back here at home, the prices of holiday food staples seem to be stable until the end of 2022. The president of the Amalgamated Supermarkets Association says they don't expect any movement in prices since there is currently enough supply of Noche Buena and Medianoche items. He adds there are still a lot of promo deals available as manufacturers try to hit their sales targets.
Kung ito pong magki-Christmas ay walang changes, kung stable yung supply nila, ito naman pong mag-New Year, after a week, meron po bang paggalaw tayong inaasahan or still the same?
Not very likely coming from the suppliers. If ever yung sinabi kong kinulang ang supply, yun ang ano doon. Kasi around by the 15th of December, medyo ano na, production, medyo nag-stop na yan, nag-hold na yan, di ba? So wala nang changes normally in prices coming from suppliers. Yeah.
Shopping malls in Metro Manila can now return to their normal operating hours. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority says they may begin their operations as early as 9 in the morning to give the public more time to do some last-minute Christmas shopping. Authorities earlier told malls to operate from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. during the holiday season to avoid traffic buildup. But they now say the anticipated congestion during the Christmas season did not come to pass due to preemptive measures. A check now on the holiday exodus. Metro Manila traffic authorities allow provincial buses to use EDSA this holiday season. Zian Ambrosio joins us on the line for more. Zian?
Denise, influx passengers were seen at the Baliwag Transit in Quezon City this morning. The transit company increased their capacity by adding 15 more buses to accommodate the additional passenger load who are leaving for their provinces. According to one of the managers of Baliwag Transit, Mr. Martin San Gabriel, their passengers doubled from 3,000 passengers per day to 6,000 passengers per day. They lauded the MNDA for changing its initial policy towards EDSA, allowing the ease of travel for passengers. Before, buses were not allowed in EDSA and were asked to reroute in other roads such as Mindanao Avenue and Calayan Avenue, where they are stuck in traffic. Meantime, in the Ayala Bus Port in Quezon City, the passengers also increased by more than 500 per day, from an average of 1,200 all the way to an average of 2,000 passengers. For the bus terminal manager, Mon Legaspi, the MMD advisory to use EDSA for provincial buses is good news, although it is not impactful, because they only provide short bus trips to Pampanga, Laguna, and Batangas. Other bus managers also lauded the MMDA as they are going to benefit from the advisory to use EDSA beginning tomorrow until January 2. Even passengers thank the MMDA for this. And that's the latest here in Quezon City. Denise?
Thanks, Ian. An early Christmas gift. That's how Filipino activist Reyna May Nacino describes her temporary release from prison after posting bail Thursday. Nacino's case drew nationwide condemnation in 2020 after she was separated from her newborn child, whom she had given birth to while in prison. The infant died 3 months later.
Wala naman pong ina na dapat mapalayo sa anak. Dapat hindi po talaga maulit yun. Dahil hindi lang po ako yung nakakaranas nun. Marami pa pong kababaihan na nakakaranas po nun na pinaglalayo sa inaaresto, illegal na inaaresto, tapos nilalayo sa anak.
Lalo po kami kay Baby River.
Nacino and her fellow activists, Alma Moran and Ram Bautista, were arrested in a raid in Manila back in 2019 for alleged illegal possession of firearms and a grenade. Speaking to reporters Friday, the three reiterated their call to free other political prisoners.
Siyempre, kailangan palayain po yung political prisoner katulad po namin. Hindi lang dapat kami yung palayain ngayong Pasko rin eh. Mas masaya siguro kung mas marami po yung palayain ng mga political prisoners. Dahil ayun po yung matagal na nating panawagan.